Hey guys, I promised you I'd do a little bit of a post-mortem on my starter motor. This is the motor that I tested and studied in the last video, and I decided to take it apart to try and sort out what was wrong with it. Now this is a starter motor here, this is a solenoid, this is the B post and the trigger post, and this is the starter motor. And down here you can see the teeth of the motor, the teeth that grab the flywheel and turn the starter. You can see that when you press the teeth one way, it won't permit you to go, and the other way it slides. It's a one-way mechanism here. Now let's take this apart. I think the problem is going to be in the solenoid, and so what I've done is I've undone these 3 7-millimeter bolts, and I'll just take this top off. And you can see inside you've got a plunger, and this plunger will go up and down. And when you press the plunger up and down, you can see the teeth down at the very bottom. I don't know if you can see that, but the teeth will move in and out as well. So when this plunger dives down, it slides the teeth into engagement with the flywheel. Now, how does this all work? Well, let's take it apart and see. You can see I've got a spring that holds the plunger out normally. And then here, this plunger has got a circular disc which is made of copper. You see that? And this one's quite corroded and rusted, or not rusted, but certainly corroded and dirty looking, pitted. And that plunger will come up and down. Now, let's look a little closer here. I hope you can see this. If you look closely, here's the trigger post right here. And power that goes through the trigger post enters these two little wires that go down, deep down, to some windings that surround the plunger. And then from that, the wire comes back up, through to the motor, and out to ground. And so when you get power that goes through the trigger post, it dives down, activates the solenoid, which pulls the plunger down. Now, when the plunger is pulled downward, it makes contact between the copper of this ring and then these two contacts. Here's one here, and then here's the other contact here. And you can see they're quite pitted and corroded. And I think that was my problem right there. I think that problem was with these connections, these copper connections on this side and this side here. So when my plunger was pulled downward, we make contact, allowing electricity to flow from the B post through the circular disc, which can spin to any position. Each time you do it, it is allowed to spin so that it's not always making the same contact every time. And then from there, power goes through to the motor post, through the motor windings, and then off to ground. And so I think my problem is right at these contacts. Now, I subsequently learned that these contacts are easy enough to replace. You simply undo the bolts here and here, and you can replace the contacts there and there, and you can replace the plunger. And it costs about $30 for these Nippon Denso starters to do that. And I could have saved a significant amount of money if I'd done that myself. Now the catch is that up here in Canada, not only do we have to pay for parts, but we also have to pay for shipping and handling. And as it turns out, these kinds of parts, the shipping and handling is about double what the cost of the parts are. And so from a practical perspective, it's only a bit cheaper than buying a rebuilt starter motor. In any case, if I lived in the US and I had access to this again, and if I had time to do this, to wait for the parts to come, then I think that'd be an inexpensive alternative to what I chose to do in this one. Thanks for watching.